Hey YouTube, so it's been about a year and a half since I did any videos on the Certiflat CNC machine, and frankly I haven't done anything with it since then. It's just been kind of a workbench and a catch-all for throwing stuff on top of the table. I ran into a project the other day that I wanted to use the machine to do some CNC work, and that system of G code was going to be over 500 lines, and I was running off of a desktop PC using the free demo of Mach 3 that limits you to 500 lines. And so at that point I decided I was going to jump into Linux CNC. I ended up with this laptop that has a dock on it with a parallel port on the back, and the dock connects straight to the bus. And I wanted to try that to see if it was going to work for a true parallel port system. And I burned the DVD image of Linux CNC and threw it in the laptop, and I didn't download any installers or drivers or anything like that. I just threw the DVD straight into the laptop and was able to get this laptop running on Linux CNC. When I have it on the dock, it'll go into a desktop-based type-based machine, and running it with the external monitor, the latency numbers are still the same, but it's extremely laggy trying to actually run the machine. So that wasn't going to work out for me. I can, however, run a wireless keyboard and use the machine, and it doesn't seem to lag the laptop at all. So I've been really happy with that. I scratched using the Craftsman toolbox, since I found this media cart, and it just seems to be a better fit than the Craftsman toolbox, and having the laptop instead of that ginormous old PC, seems to be a better system. I've tried, after I got Linux CNC working on this, I've tried putting Linux CNC onto that laptop, that desktop, and it wasn't going to work out. So I played with it a little bit, I cut some stuff, I broke a few router bits, just crashing into the table, and still learning process. I'm not running any Linux switches on the machine. It's still just basically exactly how it was in the end of the other videos. The wires are just wire lugged together, and it's just enough to get it running, and that's it. So the next video still will be again getting this media cart into a permanent situation, and then I'll get to working on the machine again and get the wiring all squared away, limit switches in it, cable tracks and stuff like that. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.